The brain, in many ways, is the final frontier of biology. So much is still unknown. My name is Tatyana Sharpee. I'm an associate professor at the Computational Neurobiology Laboratory at the Salk Institute. Biological systems like a human body or the brain are notorious for their complexity. When this complexity is not kept under control, this leads to various diseases like epilepsy, Alzheimer's disease, cancer, diabetes, and many others. I call my area of study biological control. I'm trying to uncover the universal principles of how biological systems control themselves using mathematical framework. Just as there are physical laws that help us understand the world, such as the theory of gravity, which generalizes from small scales to cosmological scales, we hope that there are laws that will govern biological systems from microbes to human populations. A theory of biological control will include as its elements understandings of how we sense our environment, how we adapt to it, how we predict future events, and how we make decisions. My grandparents were mathematicians and my parents were physicists. I always liked solving mathematical problems from a very young age. I used data from experiments to develop new mathematical and statistical frameworks. These formulas aim to explain sensory processing and predict animal behavior. In particular, I want to figure out how we process sounds and images. Although we often take for granted the ability to see and hear, these are complicated algorithms that we yet do not know how to reproduce in a computer. I use information theory to understand how different parts of the brain communicate with each other. Many neurological diseases are failures of information processing. Information theory is commonly used in finance and communications. It is less commonly used in biological systems. Nevertheless, it has been successful in characterizing certain aspects of the vision and audition. Together with my colleagues, I believe that information theory can be very useful in describing and characterizing biological systems across scales. The disruptions in information processing underlie many disorders of visual and auditory recognition. In some cases, the person's visual acuity is fine, but they cannot recognize a face. If we understood precisely how the signals are processed in the brain, we could develop brain-machine interfaces that would help afflicted individuals to see again and recognize the world. How is it that a human can see and recognize so much of the world around us, but a robot or a phone app can only do basic image processing and would need to tap into the cloud and the internet to successfully interpret a word? I believe that the key aspect of the solution is interaction between energy and information. I feel that in many ways we are searching in the dark because there are billions of neurons in the brain and we don't know how they communicate. A theory could be like a beacon that will help us find a solution faster. If we understand how our sensory processing works, then we can find ways to cure such diseases as schizophrenia, Alzheimer's, autism, depression, and anxiety. My grandfather used to have this analogy that science is like a mountain, and most of the time you're under this mountain, but on very rare occasions a scientist is on top of the mountain when they figure something out, and for those moments we have to keep working. I apply mathematical strategies like statistics and probability theory to understand how the brain works.